once again. Today I am going to discuss with you the topic of molarity, molality and normality. So in this topic, firstly I have written about molarity. What is it? Basically, when you do the experiments in the lab, the best term which you use to know the concentration, then you can go with these three terms: molarity, molality and normality. These will let you know about the concentration of the solutions. So if you go with firstly molarity, so what is the formula for molarity? It is the number of moles dissolved in per liter of solution. The number of moles of solute dissolved per liter of solution. But if it is not in liter, if it is in liter, so you will write only NB upon V. That NB is number of moles of solute divided by volume of the solution. But if it is not given in liter, then if it is given in milliliter, then you need to multiply it with 1000. Now you will find that how to calculate the number of moles. Number of moles is equal to mass of the solute divided by molar mass of the solute. So you can represent it with W upon M. W is given mass of solute, small m, capital M is molar mass of solute. Fine. So this is about molarity. But one disadvantage of molarity is that it will change with temperature, because it is related with volume. So expansion or contraction of the solution can take place according to the temperature. As you know, that kinetic energy of the molecule is directly proportional to the temperature. As it will increase, then the kinetic energy of molecules will increase according to the expansion, and contraction will take place. So this is one of the disadvantage for it. And if you talk about molality, it is equal to the number of moles of solute divided by weight of the solvent in kilogram. It is a number of moles of solute divided by weight of the solvent in kilogram. Or if mass of the solvent is in gram here, then you need to multiply it with 1000. This is a formula I am telling you, and the unit according to it will be moles per kg. And the advantage of using the molality is that it will not change with the temperature, because it is depending upon the weight of the solvent, not on the volume. Apart from it, if you go with normality, it is number of gram equivalent of solute divided by volume of the solution in liter, right? Number of gram equivalent of solute divided by volume of the solution in liter. But if the volume of the solution is given in milliliter, once again you will multiply that with 1000. But now you must know that what is gram equivalent of solute. So gram equivalent of solute is mass, molar mass. I am writing here once again, molar mass divided by acidity or basicity. Acidity or basicity. So this is a formula to calculate the equivalent mass, right? In the next part, I will let you know that what is the meaning of acidity and basicity. Thank you.